Hello everyone. Let's begin today's session. So let me share the screen first, okay, and then we'll see concepts as well as the questions we are going to solve. Okay, so I'll start with the concepts. Okay, so there are a few concepts which we are supposed to learn. Okay, so I'll start with very basic things. Okay, so first of all, which means one thing which you need to know is that fraction to percentage conversion. Okay, so now when we say percentage, okay, percentage means out of 100. Okay, now when we say fraction, fractions are generally out of 1. Okay, so if I write, let's say 2 by 5, okay, if I were to convert this into percentage, what I need to do is 2 by 5 into 100, and then we can easily add 40%. So when we are calculating, okay, so in fact, in any kind of calculation of percentages, we don't need percentages per se. Okay, we are just converting from fraction to percentage actually. Now in school, okay, what we are means we are taught that we should consider percentages. Means percentages are given higher means visibility or higher means I'll say time compared to fractions. Okay, because when you see number of out of 100, that's quite means you can make sense of it better. Let's say you see you got 80 out of 100, you can make better sense of it compared to somebody saying 4 by 5. Okay, so that is the primary reason. Okay, and in fraction, what can happen is you can have multiple means. Fraction can be in form of, let's say, 3 by 7, it can be 5 by 2, it can be 2 by 7. So the denominator part can be different. Okay, so but in percentages, denominator is always 100. So the understanding is pretty much clear. Okay, straight. Okay, but when we talk about from calculation point of view, it's always better to consider fractions. Okay, and I'll tell you how and why. Okay, and what are the means fractions we are supposed to know. Okay, so obviously everyone knows that 1 by 1 is 100%. 1 by 2 is 50%, 1 by 3 is 33.3%. Okay, so I'll take means I'll just cover a few percentages which are important. Okay, you should also know 2 by 3. Okay, most of us know that this is 66.67 or 66.66. Okay, then we have 1 by 4, which is 25%, 3 by 4 is 75%. Then we have 1 by 5 is 20%, 2 by 5 is 40%, and so on. Okay, then you can start with 1 by 6, which is 16.66%. I'll add 5 by 6 as well, which is 83.33%. 1 by 7 is an important one. Okay, there's something which is very important for CAT or any competitive exam, especially MBA entrance exam. There are a lot of questions which you get based on 1 by 7, which is 14.2. Okay, we should also know what is 2 by 7, which is equal to 28.56. My mistake, I was in a bit hurry. I wanted to write 3 by 7, which is 42.85%. Okay, so these are the percentages you are supposed to know. Okay, then 1 by 8 is 12.5. Now, how to remember these percentages? I think 1 by 2, it's everything is fine. 1 by 3 is fine. 1 by 4 is half of 1 by 2. 1 by 5, we know, is 20%. 1 by 6 is half of 30. 1 by 3. 1 by 7, 7 is a prime number, so we have to directly know. 1 by 7 is 14.28. 1 by 8 is half of 1 by 4, which is 25 by 2, 12.5%. 1 by 9 is 1 third of 30, 1 by 3, which can be written as 1.11. 1 by 10, we all know. 1 by 11 is, 11 is a prime number, so we are supposed to know 9.09%. So till this point, 1 by 12 also I can write 8.33%. Okay, so you should know all these percentages. If you know that, your calculation will be damn good. Okay, now that is something which is required. Okay, so one argument is, okay, that CAT actually tests you for understanding of concepts, but ultimately to get an answer, you need to calculate, okay, be it a DILR section or a quantitative aptitude section. In case you are slow in calculating, okay, you are wasting more time on clerical work rather than applying concepts. So you need to be good at that as well. So that is why, that is the reason we should be really good at calculation, especially percentage-based calculation, because as I told before, that this is the second most important topic after comprehension. Okay. It's reading comprehension is the most important topic, but percentage is second most important topic. Reason being, application of percentages are there in multiple concepts in quantitative aptitude, as well as there are questions in data interpretation, logical reasoning, where you need to have good understanding of percentages. And if you know these things, your means the your calculation and everything will be fast. And a lot of time, when you're reading the question, you can anticipate what you're supposed to calculate also. Okay. So this is the percentage of the fraction conversion we have already seen again. Now, first concept which we are supposed to learn today is something called initial to final value. Okay. Let's say we are given something is 100%, 100. If we are increasing it by, let's say, 25%, what we do is we write 125. If we increase by 25%, we can directly write as 1.25. So when we are calculating initial to final value, a lot of time it's better to calculate, means you're not supposed to calculate 25%, you can directly calculate 1.25 into that number. That way your calculation could be faster again. So always remember, 1 plus percentage is your multiplying factor. I call it this thing, 1 plus percentage change. If it's positive, it's plus, if negative, is minus. So this is what I call multiplying factor. So when you're calculating, okay, initial to final value, it's better to use this unless your number is pretty much straightforward. Let's say 100 to 25%, 125 is better. Okay, but let's say you have 168 and you have to find, let's say, 14.28%. Okay, 14.28% increases 1 by 7. Now, this multiplying factor, if you're increasing by, let's say, 14.28%, so this multiplying factor is 1 plus 1 by 7. So it will be how much? 8 by 7. Okay, so you have to multiply 168 into 8 by 7. So you divide by 7, you'll get 24. 24 into 8, you'll get 192. So that's how you calculate. Okay, so that is one thing which you can implement, okay, in your calculation to calculate faster. Okay, so this is something which is on the initial level you're supposed to do. Okay, and it's just matter of practice. Okay, if you start doing it, you will get better. Okay, especially when you are dealing with numbers which are not, I'll say, good looking numbers. What I mean by good looking numbers is like 100, 200, 500. Okay, where division and everything is pretty much simple. Okay, multiplying is also simple. Okay, and if you're finding percentage, it will divide by 100. Okay. But when we are talking about numbers which are not beautiful in the sense round of numbers नहीं बात कर रहे, उस केस में दी दिस विल बी अ ग्रेट हेल्प. ओके, सो व्हाट आई वांट यू गाइस टू डू इज, ओके वेट अ सेकंड, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट पार्ट. ओके, देन नेक्स्ट सी, अगेन नेक्स्ट पार्ट अगेन, सो वी विल सी टू कॉन्सेप्ट फर्स्ट, देन विल प्रैक्टिस. ओके, next type of question, okay, is we are given initial value and final value given. These two are given. You have to find percentage change. Now, how we go about it? Okay, means the school definition is final minus initial by initial into 100. Everyone, okay, so that's how we write the definition. Am I right, everyone? You can means respond on chat. That's what we know, percentage change. Okay. Now, I can write this as final minus initial minus 1 into 100. Everyone? Clear? So when you're given initial and final value, okay, what you should do is find this. Do this. Okay. Whatever you get, you have to write minus one and then you have percentage change. So this will make your calculation much more faster because final minus initial, you are anyways, when you're finding percentage change, you have to divide at least once. Okay. Exactly once means when you're dividing it, okay. When you're doing it, you are dividing one and then subtracting from one from it is pretty much easier. So this is what you need to do. Okay. So let's say I'll give you one case. Okay. Initial value is, let's say 120. Final value is, let's say 192. What is percentage change? Please respond on chat, everyone. Answers, guys. Shipra, Abhiram, Nash, Abhijit, Ayush, Harini, Dipanshu. Am I audible, everyone? Means everyone means please one of you respond so that I can understand whether you are understanding it or not. Okay. Yeah. So what is the answer of this? What is the percentage change in this case? Percentage. Okay. So probably in this case, if you subtract and you calculate, you'll be better off. Okay. Now I'll give you another question. Okay. Let's say we have one by, let's say two. One by two initial value and final value is 2 by 3. Now what is percentage change? Okay, guys, please respond on chat. What will be the percentage change in this case? Note maker, Umesh, you can also respond. Ganesh, Jyoti. Very good, Abhiram. Nidhi. So what we can do here is I can write final by initial as 2 by 3. 1 by 2, which is 4 by 3, minus 1, 1 by 3, which is equal to 33.3%. Okay. So always remember, okay, that it's not the case that this is the best way to solve. Okay. But when numbers are not so good looking and calculation can be tricky, then it makes a lot of sense to use this. Okay. So now everyone aware means clear what I'm trying to convey here. Now I'll give you some questions, okay, and I'll give you a very limited amount of time to solve these questions, okay. So just a minute, okay. And then we'll come to one interesting, then we'll see two more interest three more interesting concepts, okay. And wait a second, let me share while here. Okay, guys, can you see this, everyone? Okay, Dell, what's your name, please? Okay, it doesn't seem good to call someone Dell. Okay. Unless it's a real name. What's your name? Okay, Samantha. Okay, so what we discussed is that when we are calculating how to calculate faster. Okay, so I'll just give you one example. Okay, in this case, okay. So when we are using, so two things we have talked about so far. One thing is that we need to have means no fraction to percentage conversion, which is you should know, let's say 1 by 3 is 33.33%. If you're given, let's say 14.28%, which is 1 by 7. So fraction to percentage conversion is something which you should know. If you know a fraction to percentage conversion, your calculation will become very, very fast, okay, especially when we are dealing with such numbers. Okay, let's say question number 9, 28.56, which is 2/7. Okay, or let's say 12.5%. 125 to multiply karna is not easy, but when 12.5% is 1/8, then it becomes very, very easy. 11.11 is 1/9, and so on. Okay, so this one, 10%, what will be the final value? I'll write 17. Okay, everyone, what is this value? 19.6. What will be this value? 37.5. okay, so what we are doing here is, okay, 70% is very easy. 70% of 10 is 7, plus add kar diya. 14% is a 40 is, again, we are till the point we are in good looking numbers, calculate directly. Okay, 40% is 40 is 5.6, add kar diya. 25% of the half is 12.5, you add these. Okay, later on we'll use the fractions again. So I want everyone to solve these 12 questions, okay, remaining in less than, let's say, 3 minutes. Start typing the answers directly, typing the answers on the chat box, everyone. No need to calculate. Okay, don't use pen or any means. Okay, so start writing directly on the chat your answers from fourth one. Start everyone writing answers, everyone. I'm waiting for your answers. बहुत कैलकुलेशन नहीं करना इसके लिए यार. ओके, फोर्थ वाला ट्रिकी, दैट्स व्हाई. ओके, याद दिया ये सुनील, यू कैन नाउ जस्ट बिकम सुपर फास्ट. सो आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ यू अटेंडेड द यस्टरडेज क्लास वेयर वी टॉक्ड अबाउट द 5 का 12. नहीं नहीं नहीं, ओके, 12, सॉरी, डिक्रीज 5 का 12. गुड अभिजीत, ओके. सो वन मोर थिंग एवरीवन, ओके, सिंस ऑल ऑफ यू आर सिंसियरली अटेंडिंग क्लासेस फॉर सो मीन्स डेज, ओके, सो मेनी डेज, आई विल टेल यू वन थिंग. ओके, इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो टेबल्स टिल 25. If you know that, your life will be pretty easy, okay, especially, okay, so dekho, means, as I told you in the beginning, all of us want to become managers, okay, but then we should be good at accountants as well. Okay, that means, yes, Kashyap, that will be shared on YouTube, okay, there's a delay, okay, which, so we will share it tomorrow, both mental maths 1, mental maths 2. Okay, so 12 into 6 is how much? 132, I add 132, I'll get 1250. 40% of 20 is 8, so I'll subtract 8, I'll get 12. 15% of 20 is 3, so I'll get 17. 20% of this number is 45, so increase, we'll get 270. 10% of this number is 2, we'll get 22. This is 2/7, so I have to divide this number by 7. 30, 30 into 2 is 60. 60 add karenge, I'll get 270. 12.5% is 1/8, 1/8 is 30, you'll get 270 again. 1/9, you divide this number by, number by 9, or you see 11.11 is 1/9 plus 1 is 10/9, you divide by 9 is 26, 26 into 10 is 260. 1/6 of this number is 40, so you'll get, decrease, okay, decrease, so it will be 208. My mistake, so this is 208. Everyone, okay, 1/6, 40, subtract 240. Increase of 1/7, 320. Increase of 2/9, you divide it by, 2/9. Now this number is not divisible by 9, if you see. That is something which you should be aware of, okay. So if you divide by 9, you will get how much? You'll get 3, then you'll get 6, so you'll get 7, you'll get 2, 7, so on. Okay. Into 2, because I have calculated 1/9. And then you add, okay, so you will get how much? 404.5. okay, double of this is 74.54, so I have added that. Okay, 1/9 of this number is still, means 1/11, sorry, 1/11 of this number is 20 degrees, so we'll get 200. Everyone got it? So when you are given percentages, you calculate using fraction, you'll be damn fast. So everyone clear what I'm trying to convey here? Anyone, any doubt, question? Yes, sure. I'll share this means link of this class sheet on the means chat itself. Okay, I have not uploaded it on internet. Means I'll do it okay at the end of the class, and I'll share the link. Okay. So everyone got it, what we are supposed to do? Okay, so now I think first one I have taken a lot of means I have solved by myself only, so I would like you guys to try 16 to 30. Okay, and I want you to respond faster. Okay, start the 16s, everyone from 16. Okay, start directly like writing your answers. Okay, you can directly write fractions also and see. Good, dear Sunil, very good, excellent. Next one, next last. Yep, guys, very good, Samantha, very good, Abhijit. Nidhi, Sri Lakshmi, Hindu, Yash, answer. A18 is 160, not 160 to be precise. It will be 166.66. Okay, so just look at it. Okay, I see the common factor 9. I'll write 7 by 5 minus 1. 2 by 5 is 40%. I see this as 3 by 2. 3 by 2 minus 1 is 50%. All these calculations can be done mentally, everyone. Okay, whatever I'm writing, that can be done. It is 8 by 3. 8 by 3 minus 1 is 5 by 3. 5 by 3 is 166.66%. 5 by 3 is 1 plus 2 by 3. 2 by 3 is how much? 66.66%. Plus 1 is 100%. So we have 166.6%. Or 7%. 6.7 also you can write. Okay. This one is 10 by 6. Everyone? Or 5 by 3, which is 5 by 3 is how much? Increase of 2 by 3. So we can write 66.67%. This is 16 ka table. If you know, great. If you don't know, you have to write as 96 by 80, which is 1.2. 1.2 is 20%. This is straight away 15%. This 22, I think, okay, yes, very good, excellent. Okay, it's 5 by 7, which is reduction of 2 by 7. I'll write minus 28.56. Everyone? Okay, next one. 1 by 2 divided by 2 by 3, it will become 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is how much? Increase of 50%. Okay, everyone. Sure. Okay, now next few will take some time, so wait for people to join in our. So then to sorry. Becomes how much? 1. Is not 33.33. It is actually 66.66. 5 by 6 by 1 by 2, you'll get 5 by 3. 5 by 3 is 1 plus 1 minus, if you subtract 1, you get 2 by 3. 2 by 3 is 66.66%. Now, guys, I'm setting the expectations also as in terms of how much speed you should have. Okay, it means as in the kind of speed which I have right now. This is not great, I would say. Means I'm not great at calculation, I would say. I'm decent. Okay, but then if you need to means have good score, you need to have decent speed. Okay, So that is something which you need to focus on. Okay. So after means learning these methods which we are learning today, your task is whenever you're calculating, okay, you have to become lazy. Lazy in the sense, don't use pen. Try to look at number and identify without using pen when you calculate. When you do that, you'll be faster. Remember, your hand is fast. Sorry, your mind is faster than your hand. 5 by 6 by 1 by 2 is 5 by 3, which is equal to how much? 2 by 3, which is 66.66% or 67.8. 4 by 7 divided. Niche chal jayega, ho jayega, ye upar chal jayega. Sorry, 7 niche chal jayega, toh 14 ho jayega. Okay. And so 12 by 14, 6 by 7, 6 by 7 is reduction of 1 by 7, this is equal to how much? 14.28 ka reduction. 26. 48 का इंक्रीज. सो इस केस में सबट्रैक्शन इज गुड. व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग 26 सबट्रैक्ट यू विल बी फास्टर. रीजन बीइंग 120 12 इज वेरी ब्यूटीफुल नंबर टू सबट्रैक्ट डिवाइड. 48 बाय 12 यू विल गेट 40%. ओके नेक्स्ट दिस इज अगेन 24 बाय 40 यू विल गेट 40%. ऑल्दो आई नो 64 बाय 40 इज आल्सो 1.6. दिस इज 2 बाय 3 माइनस 1 बाय 3. 1 इज माइनus 1 बाय 3 सो यू विल गेट minus 33.33%. I think there's no. Wait. 28, yes, not 50%. Final 12 by 8 is 2 by 3. Abhijit, you subtract minus 1, so you get minus 33.33%. Abhijit and Yash, clear? Next, 5 by 6 divided by 3 by 4. So we get 20 by 18 is 10 by 9. 10 by 9 is 1 by 9 increase, 11.11. Clear? So next, this one 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. Okay, so this is equal to 9 by 8, which is increase of 1 by 8, which is 12.5%. So yes, so this is increase. Clear, everyone? Getting the point? सबको लर्न करने में अच्छा लग रहा है कि नहीं लग रहा? टेल मी, आर यू गाइस लाइकिंग इट? या आयुष, यू वांट टू से समथिंग? ओके, आई थिंक अनइंटेंशनली हो गया. ओके ओके, नाउ दिस इज प्रीटी मच इजी. ओके बेसिक थिंग. ओके नाउ guys, remember, okay, now what we have done is we have calculated percentage only, okay, but when we are calculating, means when we are solving questions in maths or DILR, there's a lot of application of these things into the profit and loss, discount. Okay, so in let's say QA section, we get around 40% questions from arithmetic. Out of these 40% questions, okay, we get around 15% questions, means every year 5 to 6 questions based on commercial maths. I'll say 15% of QA section, okay, is commercial maths, where you have to use percentages only. Okay. The fundamentals mean that, well, means things can change. Initial, let's say we are dealing with profit and loss, initial value is always cost, final value is always selling price. Okay. When we are dealing with discount, initial price is always the mark price, the final value is selling price. If we are dealing with, let's say, a percentage means interest, the amount is final value. Okay, the initial value is the principal. Okay. So remember, the calculation remains the same. We are just changing the name of initial and final. That's how we are supposed to do it. So that's means. So 5 questions out of those 34 questions, okay, or 5 to 6 questions, the problem means probably again that is the pattern which I have seen. Okay, over the last 3 years, this year number is reduced. Okay, so still it will be 15 to 18% of the question will come from percentage based calculation. And then on top of that, we have questions from DILR also, where also these concepts, the basic calculation is used. Okay, so once you know initial and final thing, then you have to just substitute cost or let's say selling price, and the whole thing remains the same, the calculation and everything. Now let's move to the one more part. Okay, next thing, okay, which I'll just tell you. Okay, Next part of calculation which we are supposed to need, third thing which we are supposed to learn today is successive percentage change. Now this is a concept which means, okay, let's say I had 100 rupees I invested in a scheme, okay, which gave me, let's say, 25% increase, okay. Then later on I invested same money in some other, the total amount in some other scheme which gave me a return of, let's say, 33.33%, okay. And then later on the whole sum was invested in something else which resulted in a loss of 10%, and we are supposed to find what is this amount, okay. So this is what we call successive percentage change. What you are supposed to do is, this number can be written as x, any number. For this one I'll write 1 plus increase of 1 by 4, so I'll write 5 by 4 multiplying factor. For this one, what will be the multiplying factor? Anyone would like to respond? 33.33% is increase of 33.33%. What will be the multiplying factor? Multiplying factor is 1 plus percentage change. So what should I write? Anyone? Kirti, Naina, anyone would like to respond? Very good. Okay, so it's 1 plus 1 by 3, which is 4 by 3. Very good. Then this can be written as 9 by 10. Now, whatever the initial value is, this is our final value. Okay, so this initial value can be 500, 10,000, anything. Okay, we have to just multiply with this. So this is what we call successive percentage change. Clear, everyone? The application of this is in real life, or real life concept is in, okay, all of you must have studied in the school, is compound interest. In compound interest, this percentage generally remains the same. So that's why, let's say you are getting return of 10%, you write 11 by 10 into number of years, okay, which can be written as 1.1 plus r divided by 100, okay, and the time, and the principal is p. So remember, this is how that is the logic behind it, okay, the compound interest formula. So that is, compound interest is nothing but successive percentage change, okay. Now again, whenever you're getting questions related to it, you can use it, okay. Alternatively, when we get questions in let's say in the form of A gave something to B and earned a profit of something, B sold it to C and lost something, in those type of question, this is what we can use to calculate faster. So I would like you guys to solve these questions now. You can take out your pen paper, you can use fractions to solve these questions again and calculate faster. So let's start with question number 31 to 45. Everyone? Start calculating, everyone. Question number 31, answer. Very good, Yogesh. So I can write it as 231 into, this is 1 by 11 decrease, so I'll write 10 by 11 into increase of 1 by 7, so I can write it as 8 by 7. Then we can calculate 21, 3, 240. So initially you can write and calculate. Later on, as I told you, if you want to become faster at calculation, you have to become lazy. Jitna aalsi banoge utna fayda hai, utna calculation faster hoga. So I'll give you example. 440 divided by, hum log ko de rakha hai, 25% decrease and 22.29 increase. Okay, so initially I'll write 442 by 22.22 is 11.11 का डबल, which is 1/9 का डबल, so 2/9, so I'll write 11/9. Decrease of 25%, I'll write 3/4. Now again, if you see this number won't be divisible by 9, so we'll get a very not so good looking number, but we'll get something. Okay, so I'll write 1210 divided by 3, which will give us 403.33. So makes our calculation easy. Okay, now this one, 20% decrease. So 20% of this decrease of this is 48 minus cutting 192. 192 1 by 6 is 32. So I'll get 160. Everyone, so this is what successive percentage changes. 230, 222. Shwetendu, which question you have answered? 233.98. I can write 480 by 7 by 6, then 6 by 5. Okay, 5 se divide karenge, then we'll get 96. 96 into 7, we'll get 96 into 6 is 576 plus another 96 will give us 672. Number three, 160 मिलेगा ना? Am I wrong? We are decreasing twice, Ajit. Sorry, Swarnendu. 33 का will decreasing twice. So 240 divided by 240 into 4/5 into 5/6. So 5/5 cancelled out. So we have to just find 2/3 of it. Okay. Then 240, 4/5 into 5/6. Okay, 2/3. Karna, I think this is repeated. This is 160. Yes. Next, this one. 420 increase of 16.6. So I'll write 7/6. Increase of again. So I'll write 6/5. So we have to find 7/5 of this number. Okay, which will mean 84 into 7. Okay, 588. Okay, I am not calculating. I am assuming Ajit is right. Thank you, Ajit. Okay. 60% increase, so I can write 220 into 8/5 into 5/5. So this cancelled out beautifully. We'll get 440. So everyone, so shall we solve more questions or shall we go to the next concept? I think you guys are pretty much clear what we are trying to achieve here. Okay, sure. Now the next thing which we are supposed to learn, okay, this is something which is really, really important. I feel okay. I feel you understand this, then you are the difference between, I'll say, basic level of understanding of percentages and I'll say moderate level of percentage, moderate level of understanding of percentage, that is the difference which creates, okay, which I'm telling you right now. So one thing which we have seen before, okay, so point number four, I'm writing something here, then I'll explain. So one thing which we have seen before is initial to final. So if I have 100, if I'm increasing by 25%, so I'll add 1. I can write it as this as 1 plus 25%, or I can write it as 5/4. So if this initial value is 400, what will be the final value? Anyone? What should I do? What will be the final value? Yash, Avijit, Shilakshmi, what will be the final value? 500. So this is nothing but I'm writing 400 into this 1 plus 25%. I can write it as 5/4, or this whole thing again. You can just write it. If you don't want to write fraction, you can write 1.2. Everyone? So this, the percentage change works is what I call unitary method. Okay, it means as in you are given the initial value, you have the final value. For certain sum, you're getting something. For if you change number to one, you'll get something. That is what I call multiplying factor with respect to one. Now, if I tell you, okay, so let's say the final value is 650, and we are increasing it by 25%. What will the initial value? Pretty simple, not very difficult to understand. Okay, but still, how will you calculate it? Initial value is something which is supposed to find. Final value is 650. Tell me, guys, what will be the initial value? Nidhi, Nayana, would you like to answer? Okay, very good. Samantha. Okay. So what we are supposed to do? Okay. So how did you calculate? I mean, so from means in the school, what how we okay? Very good, Kashyap, Yash. Okay. So what in the school what we learned was something like this. This you will get 650. You get 1.25% x, and you get 650. So what I'm telling you is that instead of this, okay, when you're calculating, you need to do this. 650 divided by 5 by 4, the multiplying factor. So when we are going from initial to final, we multiply with what plus percentage change. Okay. Automatically, obviously, if there's a decrease, we'll have right minus. So I'm writing plus minus. When we are going from final to initial, you should divide. And that saves a lot of time. Okay. So what you do is you divide by. Okay. So if we are given selling price and we have to find the cost price, in case we are solving a question where we are given the percentage, sorry, profit percentage, that is how we can do it. Okay. So as I told you, everything initial, final, this percentage concept, if you understand clearly, you have to just substitute initial and final with those concepts, those terms, cost, selling price, everything. Okay. So that is something which you should keep in mind. Okay. So let's start, everyone. So with 46, what we are supposed to do? Okay, we have to find the answer. Okay, so I'll write 280 divided by 5 by increase here 5 by 4 because 25% is 1 by 4. So how much we'll get is 56 into 4, which is 220. Everyone, sounds faster? Looks faster to solve? Yes, no, everyone. So, okay, now I'll start. Let's start with question number 47, everyone. I'll wait for a couple of minutes, and then when answers will start pouring in, I'll just solve these questions. So 47 to start karo. I'll give you around 5 minutes. Sorry, not 2 minutes. Let's take 5 minutes to try to solve as many questions as possible. Okay, and write your answers in chat box. Then I'll tell you how to solve these questions faster. Okay, so let's write 60 by, now the increase is 125%, it's not 25%, so this will become 9 by 4. Okay, everyone, is it clear? How did we come arrive at this 9 by 4? Okay, so when we write this, okay, so we will get 80 by 3, which is 26.6. For this one, 40 by 6 by 5. So this will become 33.33. Not percentage, obviously. My mistake. This one, 200 divided by 5 by 4. So this is 160. This is 25 divided by, not 15% can be written as 3 by 20. So I have to write 23 by 20. This is 500 by 23. So I have deliberately given some numbers which are not good looking. Okay, so that you need to write and solve. Okay. So this will become 221.73, 460. Okay, 483, 17. So I'll get around. Next, this one. 35 divided by this is equal to 3 by 7. So I'll write 10 by 7. Okay. So this is actually what? How much will it say? Okay. So 10 by 7. So I'll get how much divide by 2. So 24 point. Everyone getting it? What we are trying to do here? Question 50 is pretty straightforward. 55 by 1.1 will get 50. This one is 91.1.3, so we get 70. 54, 126 by 9 by 8. So if I divide by this by 9, I'll get how much? 1 and 14. 14 into 8, 112. This one, again, I think this is same as something which we have written before, so I'm just erasing it. 42 divided by 8 by 7. Okay. So again, this will be a bit complicated in terms of calculation. Okay. So we'll get how much? 147 divided by 4 is we'll get 46 point something. Okay. That is something which I can leave. Okay. This is 100. This is also 100. This one is 234 divided by 9 by 8. So if I divide by 9, I'll get 200. Sorry, 9. If you divide by 9, you'll get 26. Okay. Yes, 26 and into 8. So you can just subtract it. You'll get 208. This one, 138 divided by 23 by 20. So you'll get 120. Everyone clear what we are trying to do here? No, percentage value is not multiplying factor. Okay, Avijit is asking, okay, confusion with multiplying factor. So first we have to add 1 plus. Okay, so I'll just go to here, go to the explanation again. You see, so when you're going from initial to final, okay, so multiplying factor is 1 plus percentage change. Okay, so when you are going from initial to final, you multiply with it. When you're going from final to initial, you have to just divide by it. That is a simple funda we can use, Vijit. So multiplying factor is 1 plus percentage change. Okay, so for initial to final, multiply. For final to initial, it's division. Obviously, is it clear or means do you have still have any confusion? So let me take the last example again. So here in this case, multiplying factor is 1 plus 15%. Okay. So I can write 138 divided by, either I can write 1.15, okay, or I'll directly write it as 3 by 20. This 15% is 3 by 20. So this multiplying factor will become 23 by 20. So I write 130 by 1.15, or I write 23 by 20. Am I clear, Abhijit, now? Okay. So that is all I had for you guys to teach, okay, in terms of the mental maths calculation. Okay. There are some tips which I want to give you, okay, which you can apply, okay, if you want to become good at calculation, because you have enough time to improve your calculation. So first thing, whenever you are calculating, try not to use calculator, okay? If you do that, then you are forcing yourself to calculate, okay? Second thing is, try as much as not doing calculation with multiplication or division, okay? How to do that? Remember you have to mug up all the tables. Use tables to find values, okay, in terms of multiplication or division, okay. And third thing is, okay, when you are looking at number, okay, try to visualize, means without solving, okay, think what can be the approximate value. That is really, really important, because once you start getting hang of the numbers, okay, when you see the numbers and you can understand what is the approximate value, okay, in terms of division or multiplication, okay, a lot of time you need not calculate from, means if you check the options. That is also important, okay? So these three things you need to keep in mind. Tables, okay. Then second thing is, do not use calculator. Third thing is, do not use even pen and paper to solve questions, or okay, to do calculation as much as possible. Sometimes you need to do it, okay, but try using as less as possible, okay? So if you force yourself, then you will obviously start thinking about the methods which can be used to make your calculation faster. So some of the methods, okay, which we have discussed in the last two classes will be really, really helpful if you are, or you want to implement that, okay? So that is the message, everyone, okay?